please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Mr. Tulsian, this is a very crunching fall on Mothers and Sumi now, 252 on the stock.
That's right, Anujan. In fact, it is very surprising. Maybe, you know, again, people have started talking of the slowdown in the Europe and all sort of things because of the trade tariff war. And if we see that effect, you know, if we see that things coming up, then, you know, you have the Mothers and Sumi taking a big beating because of their strong Europe presence and, you know, exporting to many countries and all that. But yes, it's indeed very surprising. Yeah.
Mr. Tulsian, your thoughts on actually on a stock like Tata Steel, because the commentary that we have been getting is fairly bullish in terms of just the prices, and I believe there were some price hikes in August as well. But in this kind of an uncertain environment, is there any point trying to play the metal, specifically the ferrous theme?
See, we have been keeping positive on ferrous steel, and in fact, if this import tariff items likely to get announced, are going to see the inclusion of the steel items also. I'm referring ferrous because China will be definitely desperate. They will cut the prices and they will be having the closure also ahead of that winter closure, and this time it is likely to be quite long. So maybe from inventory clearance point of view, because the closure of the steel plants will start from October, which this time is going to last maybe till end of February, which otherwise, you know, comes to an end in the end of or middle of January. So maybe that will be seen quite positive for the steel stocks. But in the morning also, I've said that on Friday, we have seen the GDR of Tata Steel, you know, falling on the global exchanges by about 6-8%, and the stretching of the balance sheet with the loan having crossed about 1 lakh crore and the kind of acquisitions they have been going for. I'm not saying that the acquisitions or the inorganic growth move is not seen to be good, because they are acquiring the Usha Martin steel plant of 1 million ton special alloy steel. So that is all seeing the pressure. Probably the things may get, integration may happen in the next 12 months. Till then, they may be having the pressure on the margins. Also, taking all this into consideration, my preference will be more on the JSW Steel and Steel Authority, and maybe third in the pecking order will be Jindal Steel and Power.